of time in the Bible telling us who we are. It's almost as if he knew that we would doubt who that was from time to time. It's as if he saw it coming, that we'd spend our whole lives searching for what our identity, what our real name was, and that there'd be many moments in our lives where we'd let different kinds of names define us. When we looked in the mirror, compared ourselves to pictures, and heard the name ugly. When we've been left by loved ones, people we trusted once, and heard the name unworthy. When we've been drowning in discouragement, living in a seemingly never-ending crisis, and heard the name forgotten. When we've had our hopes up and our hearts open, only to be brought down by closed doors, and we've heard rejected. When we look for infinite affirming love through lesser physical fleshly versions. When we give it away or when it was stolen, and we hear impure, we hear garbage. When we go to other vices to ease our pain, and we hear addict, we forever broken, when we feel like we're living in the shadow of someone else's calling, and we hear second place, when our pain cripples us to a point where we don't even know how to let others in, and we hear lonely, when our path seems too gross for others to forgive, and we hear disgusting, it's overwhelming, these voices we're constantly hearing, it's suffocating, this air of constant critique and comparing, and it's sort of amazing. The people whose voices I've allowed to name me. The power I've given to my past, to my mirror, and to my surroundings, and enabled them to identify me. The amount of years I've spent living up to whatever others say over me. But God says something else about me. It's like he knew there would be other voices, so he wrote his voice down in a timeless book of truths that would remind us over and over again in the moments when lies would block his truths and somehow make us forget. I'm going back to the source, not the people I've allowed to represent God to me, but the actual, literal, tangible words that he has written down for me. And there's some other name he's given to me. John 15:15, he calls me friend. 1 Thessalonians 1:4, he calls me chosen. Ephesians 2:10, he calls me his workmanship. He calls me his art. He calls me handmade. He calls me purposed and fashioned for good things. 1 Corinthians 6:19, he calls my body a temple. He calls it the residence of the Holy Spirit. Acts 1:8, he calls me his messenger to the world. Galatians 3:26, he calls me his child. Romans 5:8, he calls me greatly loved. John 8:36, he calls me free, free indeed. 2 Corinthians 5:17, he calls me brand new. And it's amazing how different these names are.